Welcome to Real Scary, the home of true scary stories, where we bring you the most unnerving of content. From British ghost stories to the most gruesome of murders, if you are quite partial to a scary story, you're in the right place. The subject of today's scary story is Newsham Park Hospital, which is a Grade 2 listed building situated in Liverpool, England, and which now sadly sits derelict. It was previously a mental hospital, prior to which it was the Liverpool Seaman's orphan institution. This eerie building has acquired the reputation as being one of the most haunted former mental asylums in the United Kingdom. Pre-1869, there was no institution in Liverpool for the support, well-being and education of the orphans of British seamen. The Seaman's Orphanage, Newsham Park, was founded in 1874 and was officially opened on the 30th of September 1874 by the Duke of Edinburgh. And as of June 1884, approximately 800 fatherless children were being supported by the orphanage, half of which were living entirely at the orphanage. During World War I, the devastation left thousands of children without parents and support. Many of them, now with nowhere to turn, had no other option and were forcibly moved into Newsham Park Orphanage. Throughout their time at the orphanage, the children were treated terribly by several very sadistic matrons who kept things in order. Former residents have stated just how strict it could be and that the children would often get severely punished for even the most minor of transgressions. One previous resident explains they weren't fussy how they punished you, it was really cruel. Towards the end of the Second World War, the country's social care schemes improved somewhat, which resulted in Newsham Orphanage losing many of its children, which in turn led to a substantial reduction in revenue. And by July 1949, the orphanage was closed. However, in 1951, Newsham Park was purchased by the Ministry of Health, who subsequently opened it in 1954 as Newsham Park Hospital. The hospital had its own specialist psychiatric department, and patients from across the country, many with some of the most severe mental health issues, were admitted. Early asylums for mental patients were in essence prisons for the insane. They did not deliver the much needed treatment for those admitted, instead delivering on incarceration and restraint. And for any patient that was violent to either themselves or others, were caged, shackled, and or put in straitjackets. Being a hospital for such a long period of time, there will understandably have been deaths. Unfortunately, however, records are somewhat difficult to find in relation to Newsham Park. Some that are recorded in and around the hospital are: in 1878, Mr. William Holland, 46, a former chimney sweep, was found dead under the ice in the lake. In 1880, a man in his 50s by the name of Frank was found in the lake also, with his throat slit from ear to ear. A razor was also found in his jacket pocket. In 1891, a man by the name of Eric Archibald was found dead also in the lake. In 1897, the body of Florence Hansford, a domestic servant, was found floating in one of the lakes also. A psychiatric nurse by the name of Mabel Entwistle was found dead on the staircase by the main corridor. It is also reported that she often spoke of seeing ghosts in the hospital. A resident by the name of Edith hanged herself in the bell tower. A young orphan known only as Little Bill had been locked in the punishment cupboard by the matron on duty. He screamed and screamed until he fell silent. It was thought he had fallen asleep, but the following morning he was found dead in the lonely punishment cupboard by the day shift staff. There are substantial reports from both staff and patients regarding Newsham Park's ghost activity, and patients were constantly mentioning the children at the hospital, even though there were no children at Newsham since 1950. On one of the upper floors, which leads to the attic, stands a row of padlocked cupboards, which were referred to as the naughty cupboards by the medical staff. And any orphans who dared to step out of line were locked inside for hours, and sometimes even days, as punishment. And there have been numerous reports of a little boy opening and slamming the said cupboard doors, whilst at the same time whispering, "I am Bill, I am Bill." A matron from the building's time as an orphanage has been seen wandering in and out of the morgue, and reports state she seems to be in somewhat of a hurry. In 1984, medical staff on their way to the canteen saw the regular reported sighting of a young man by the name of Stephen, who had died at Newsham Park in 1920 at the young age of 27 from an acute lung condition. Reports state his cough can still be heard echoing throughout the building to this very day. There is also a myriad of unexplained and extremely unnerving sounds that have been witnessed, including dragging noises, terrifying screams, hysterical crying, and workmen inside the building reported growling extremely close to their ears, which on one occasion was that alarming the contractor refused to complete the works he had been tasked with. There are also reports of full-bodied apparitions, many of them untidy, lost-looking children, which predominantly manifest themselves on Ward G. Shadowy figures with disembodied voices have been reported drifting from room to room. A woman by the name of Maud, who was visiting her husband in 1979, reported to staff that she witnessed a horse on the ground floor passing through the wards. There are also reports from staff that they often felt warm breath on their necks when there was no one in close proximity. Also, many reported their hair being pulled by unseen hands. Tables would violently slide across the floor on their own, doors angrily slammed shut, and again with no one in close proximity. Could some of these spirits that still inhabit Newsham Park be of the 16,000 orphans who were cremated on site? Or could the spirits be some of the psychiatric patients still aimlessly walking round and round the building, lonely and looking for help? I will let you be the judge. Now, I have personally visited Newsham Park, and I can state the following. Upon opening the double doors and entering this eerie, uninviting building, you can feel the oppressive atmosphere instantly hit you, quickly followed by a strange mixture of smells that you just can't quite put your finger on. There are broken beds strewn in dilapidated rooms, rusting wheelchairs huddled closely together, old trolleys parked in the exact location as when they were last used, names of the staff, now long dead, displayed on old empty rickety lockers like unintentional epitaphs. The fridge doors in the morgue stand uninvitingly open, revealing the unnerving body drawers, positioned ready and waiting inside. This is truly a horrifying building. By the end of 1988, Newsham Park Hospital was no more and closed its double doors for the last time. It is now privately owned by a property developer by the name of Angle Farm Limited, who have submitted plans to turn it into an events festival. Thank you for joining me in our latest edition of Scary Stories. I do hope you enjoyed, and if you did enjoy, I would ask that you like, share and subscribe. And as always, be safe and sweet dreams.